So next, we will be looking at the next component of the ultrasound machine setup, and that is the probe. We've already looked at the console, and now we will be looking at the probe, which is the actual information gathering device of the setup. The probe is what actually goes inside the cow and releases ultrasound waves, which will then interact with the tissues within the cow and then send back a signal to be recorded by the console, which will ultimately give us an image. On the ultrasound probe, this is a rectal probe, which is a linear probe. And what that means is you have ultrasound crystals, which are located along the face of the probe here. Electricity runs down this cable and causes these ultrasound crystals to vibrate. When they vibrate, they release an ultrasound wave, which then travels down into the tissues, bounces off of structures, and is returned back to the probe. That signal is received by the console and translated into an image. The orientation of these crystals means that when the electricity hits them and they vibrate, the ultrasound wave comes down in a line like this. Therefore, you need to understand how to hold the probe to get the best possible image of whatever it is you're wanting to look at within the cow. A few features that you need to recognize are where the tip is and how that relates to what you're actually seeing on the screen. On this particular machine, this probe, the tip is located to the left side of the screen. So I know as I move forward within the cow or backwards, I will know how that relates to the image that I'm seeing. If I move the probe towards the left or forwards within the cow, the ultrasound image will be coming from the left. So anything that is on the left side of the screen will be translating to this part of the probe. Something that you need to remember is that these crystals are a bit sensitive and delicate, and we need to take care of them. So whenever you're holding the probe and it's not inside the cow, it's a good idea to actually cover the face of the probe with your hand to ensure that if you get knocked against a gate, that it won't be damaging the crystals. When you're looking to go inside the cow, the way that you hold the ultrasound probe will enable you to get better or worse pictures. So a couple of tips to remember. If you hold the probe cupped within the palm of your hand and keep one finger near to the very tip, so the very end of the probe, which will correlate to the left-hand side of the screen. You can then grasp the remainder of the probe in your hand, and with your two fingers that are free on either side, and potentially your pinky as well, you can then feel the structures that are around the probe, such as the uterus. There are four basic movements that we can do with the probe. The first is we can move forward or back. Forward or back. And that will enable us to go more cranial or towards the head of the cow, or further back towards the cervix. We also need to ensure that we have good contact at all times, because this will help us to get a clearer picture. So we need to be able to actually push down on the rectal floor. So pressure is very important as well. We don't need to use excessive pressure, but just enough to ensure we have good contact of the probe surface at all times. The next is actually rotating the probe head to be in line with whatever structure we're wanting to look at. The ultrasound wave comes out of the probe in this direction. So if we're looking at a structure that is in this orientation, we'll just need to change the orientation of the probe so that it matches the structure we're looking at. So what that would look like inside the cow is gently moving from side to side. The final movement that we can make is rocking or tilting the probe. This again will help us to get an improved level of contact with the rectal floor to improve the quality of our image. And it will also enable us to get a different view of structures within the cow. So for example, on the ovary, what we may be able to do is tilt or rock side to side so that we can look at all of the structures within the ovary, including the corpus luteum, follicles if they're present, and any potential pathology. So in summary, the ultrasound machine setup will include the console, the viewing device, and the probe. The controls that we can change on the console to improve the quality of the image, depending on whether we're looking at structures that are superficial or deep within the cow, include frequency, depth, and gain. We can also alter the way that we manipulate the probe when it's inside the cow. And the four movements that we can make are either moving forward or back, forward or back, adding pressure to improve contact. We can rotate from side to side, or we can rock or tilt the surface of the probe.